Penn State trustees fired football coach Joe Paterno and university president Graham Spanier Wednesday night. The revered head coach and Spanier were dismissed amid the growing furor over how the school handled sex abuse allegations against an assistant coach.
I would hope that everyone would agree that what we're doing is what we believe in our best judgment is in the best long-term interest of the university, which is much larger than athletic programs.
The massive shakeup came hours after Paterno announced that he planned to retire at the end of his 46th season.
I owe my career to Coach Paterno, and it's really tough to see him go.
But the outcry following the arrest of former assistant coach Jerry Sandusky on molestation charges proved too much for the board to ignore.
Well, we handled it the best way we could with the information we had and with the time that was available to us. Again, wanting to be decisive, but also wanted to be thorough and appropriately deliberate.
After hearing that Paterno and Spanier were fired, a large crowd gathered on campus, first at the administration building, then at Beaver Stadium. The winningest coach in major college football, Paterno later spoke to a smaller group of students outside his home, saying he has to get used to not being Penn State's coach.
Coach! Coach!
Play a little bit for those victories.
The 84-year-old Paterno has come under harsh criticism for not taking more action in 2002 after then graduate assistant and current assistant coach Mike McQuarrie came to him and reported seeing Sandusky assaulting a boy in a school shower. Paterno says he should have done more. Spanier has said he was not told the details of the attack. Sandusky has denied the charges. Defensive coordinator Tom Bradley will serve as interim coach. Penn State hosts Nebraska in its final home game of the season Saturday. Steve Carmazan, Associated Press.